Hello, friends. You won't believe how much we've missed you all, and how difficult the last few days were. We're really touched beyond words looking at all the lovely wishes via comments and emails. The good news is we're back in business and gonna share some latest space updates with you. First of all, we'll talk about SpaceX's launch problems due to shortage of liquid oxygen following an update regarding SpaceX's upcoming CRS-23 mission, along with ASOG drone ship's departure from Port Canaveral. We'll wrap up discussing Starship updates. Let's take a look at the update regarding delayed SpaceX launch plans due to unavailability of liquid oxygen. SpaceX's upcoming launch plans will face a major delay owing to the shortage of liquid oxygen due to the latest wave of COVID pandemic. On the 24th of August, Tuesday, at the 36th Space Symposium, Gwynne Shotwell, President and COO of SpaceX, had pointed out these launch problems due to lower supply of liquid oxygen. Liquid oxygen is a key fuel component of the spacecraft and is commonly used as an oxidizer, along with propellant fuels like kerosene, methane, and liquid hydrogen. Shotwell stated, "We're actually going to be impacted this year with the lack of liquid oxygen for launch. We certainly are going to make sure the hospitals are going to have the oxygen that they need, but for anybody who has liquid oxygen to spare, send me an email." With the rise of the Delta variant of COVID, the demand for the liquid oxygen jumped up at a shot. Most of the hospitals use liquid oxygen for meeting their oxygen needs for ventilators. Moreover, liquid oxygen is also used for filtering the water by water treatment plants. Domestic needs for treatments are also increasing, which added to the demand for liquid oxygen. The shortage of liquid oxygen has reached such a condition that on the 20th of August, residents of the city of Orlando have been ordered to reduce water usage so that more liquid oxygen can be sent to hospitals rather than using it for water treatment. According to the Orlando Utilities Commission, the supplies of liquid oxygen have been cut by nearly 50%. So it now seems that oxygen is becoming a major concern in between space launch plans, on one hand, and medical use on the other. Space launch providers other than SpaceX are also facing problems in launch due to a shortage of liquid oxygen. Bruno, chief executive of United Launch Alliance, tweeted, "The USG contractor that transports liquid GN2 to VAFB is helping with the COVID-related LOX effort in Florida. Working that situation now." According to a report, ULA's Landsat 9 launch may face delay owing to the shortage. However, Shotwell didn't clearly say how much the SpaceX launch cadence will face. From the present SpaceX's launch cadence, we can see that the last launch of Falcon 9 was carried out on the 30th of June. It's been nearly 2 months since SpaceX has carried out any further launches. So it may seem that SpaceX has been facing liquid oxygen shortage for a long time. Although, according to some reports, SpaceX focused on producing Starlink satellites with laser inter-satellite links installed, they put a brake on Starlink launches. But good news is we will not have to wait for a Falcon 9 launch, as SpaceX has already scheduled to end their launch silence by sending an upgraded Cargo Dragon mission, CRS-23, to the International Space Station on the 28th of August from the Kennedy Space Center. Our next update is regarding SpaceX's ASOG drone ship heads to the sea for the first Falcon 9 booster landing, while Falcon 9 carries out a static fire as pre-flight test. To support booster recovery of the Cargo Dragon 23 mission, SpaceX has already sent their newly made drone ship, a short fall of gravitas, to the Atlantic Ocean. From Port Canaveral, the drone ship is now heading towards 300 kilometers inside the ocean. For ASOG, this will be the first booster recovery mission. SpaceX has planned to carry out their Cargo Dragon mission on the 28th of August, Saturday. This launch will also mark SpaceX's first launch in the last 2 months, as SpaceX's workhorse, Falcon 9, was last launched on the 30th of June. As stated earlier, a short fall of gravitas is SpaceX's third and newest autonomous spaceport drone ship. Both, of course, I still love you and just read the instructions, other drone ships of SpaceX. We're more or less autonomous as they uncrew during booster landings at sea, but they need tugboats to tow it to and from the recovery zones. Also, those drone ships had crewed support from another ship. But the drone ship ASOG is truly autonomous as it can propel itself to and from the recovery area without the help of a tugboat. All processes will be carried out without any human intervention. Thus, this will also increase the pace of booster recovery. But according to recent reports, SpaceX might not rely fully on the autonomous part on its first mission. SpaceX will make out recovery operations in semi-autonomous mode. In other words, in the same way as SpaceX has done with other drone ships. According to some reports, SpaceX will not use ASOG drone ship in fully autonomous mode for the first few missions to test out the reliability of the drone ship and then gradually shift to fully automated system. Some estimates stated that SpaceX need to complete at least dozens of successful recovery missions to shift towards the autonomous part, and once that drone ship is fully usable in its automatic mode, it'll be the most technically superior recovery vessel in the world. SpaceX had sent the drone ship on one hand, and on the other hand, they've also carried out a static fire test of the Falcon 9 rocket as a pre-flight test procedure in the Kennedy Space Center. The static fire test was carried out on the 25th of August at 9 p.m. Eastern Daylight Time. On Wednesday evening, SpaceX teams carried out the test along with the Cargo Dragon payload. They've gone through a practice countdown. Later, the rocket was filled with propellant, following the 9 Merlin 1D engines were ignited, which lasted for nearly 10 seconds. According to some reports, SpaceX's Falcon tests were successful, hinting that the Cargo Dragon mission will be on time. The Cargo Dragon capsule will deliver some biomedical experiments, scientific instruments, along with food. It'll also deliver a small robotic arm made by Gitai, a Japanese company, Faraday Research Facility, an experimental package, and some CubeSats to be deployed in the future. Toyotaka Kazuki, Gitai Japan's chief technology officer, said, "This technology demonstration is to show the world that the capabilities necessary for automation in space are finally available. It provides an inexpensive and safer source of labor in space, opening the door to the true commercialization of space." The research facility carries an experiment of a remote-controlled drug conveyance system. This experiment is backed by Houston Methodist Research Institute. Two educational experiments will also be carried out in the space station. If the CRS-23 launch remains on time, then the Cargo Dragon capsule will dock with the International Space Station by the 29th of August at 11 a.m. Eastern Daylight Time. Today's last update is regarding reinstallation of 29 Raptor engines on booster number 4. SpaceX is now on the path of creating milestones. SpaceX teams have again started reinstalling 29 Raptor engines on Starship's first orbital class Super Heavy booster, this time fully directing towards static fire, then final orbital launch. In the path of creating milestones, SpaceX had earlier finished installation of grid fins on a Super Heavy Booster 4, and then installed all the 29 Raptor engines on Booster 4 in less than a day. Starship SN20 was also fitted with its 6 Raptor engines. Following it, Booster 4 was rolled out, and also the SN20 was rolled out. Then the most crucial milestone was achieved with the full stacking SN20 and BN4. Once the fit checks were completed, the two stages were separated and returned to the high bay. Once the booster came back to high bay, SpaceX teams started the secondary plumbing work on the booster. Several other electronic equipment were also installed. Eventually, the 29 Raptor engines were removed from the booster. Removal of booster engines make it probable that the engines were actually installed for fit checks in thrust structure. Nearly 11 days after removal of engines, SpaceX teams have started reinstallation of Raptor engines on the booster. As we can see that SpaceX has completed a good round of fit checks. So this time, probably, the installation will head towards direct pressure checks and static fire tests. During tests, several issues may come up, or some engines may be replaced, and on successful completion, they'll head towards orbital flight in late 2021. As per recent reports, after completion of engine installation, BN-4 will roll out to either orbital launch site or suborbital test stand. Thanks for watching. Please subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your valuable feedback in the comment section. This will help us to improve.